there will be no invitations. No pomp and circumstance to the circumstances I have otherwise been too pompous to admit. No 10 free tickets for admission. No graduate admissions. No International Convention Center at 3 p.m. Sunday, May 15. No cap. No gown. Just me. In the unsteady space between death and degree, between end and finish, take and give, live and commence. There were never invitations, you know. They came on their own, these demons that jungle gym the playground of your bones, make home in the hollow of your hells, and then live to tell the story. You, sinking ship, them Atlantic, waves of want and worry that wave at once in worry, how you wade in this here water and not drown, where crown meets crucifix, and how you made Negro spiritual of such sounds, made smile from so much pain, but there were never invitations. Depression is an unwelcome guest that makes bed and breakfast of your body and lobby of your lungs, somewhere to sit and feast until full, leaving you empty. It's empty and heavy at the same damn time, the worst kind of stillness, but there were never invitations. It's therapy in reverse. It's praying for a mercy you've convinced yourself you don't deserve. It's lateral laceration, bathroom breaks with blood. It's making common folk of a God you love and then forgetting that there is one, but there were never invitations. It's wondering if they will miss you when you were gone and writing the suicide note anyways. It's winter with no promise of fall. It's falling and feeling more comfortable there than you do on your feet. It's forgetting how to walk. It's forgetting how to breathe. It's everything. It is everything that got me here. So there will be no invitations. There were never any to begin with. No pomp and circumstance to the circumstances I had otherwise been too pompous to admit. No 10 free tickets for admission. No graduate admissions. No International Convention Center at 3 p.m. Sunday, May 15. No cap. No gown. Just me. Hoping that I am still something to celebrate. I am still something to celebrate. So come celebrate with me. Celebrate that I'm testimony and not tombstone. Phone your families, pull up a chair, pop some bottles and Millie rock to the era of 1-2s in the air. Play some spades, grab a plate. The foil is in the kitchen and the chicken is on the grill. Fill this space with anything and everything that you can find, for this is a time for celebration, and I welcome you in for a listen, because this is my story to give. This is not just my story to give. I lived. And that should know no shame.